Assalamualaikum. This is Amna Tariq, and you are watching Desi TV USA. So we are starting Women Empowerment series, and the woman which will be honored today is Begum Liaqat Ali Khan. Begum Rana Liaqat Ali Khan was one of the leading women and prominent figure in Pakistan movement, along with her husband, who not only witnessed the creation of Pakistan but also gave her services to newborn Pakistan. She was the radical lady with the new thoughts and ideas, who always become ready to give her 100% whatever the situation was. Begum Rana Liaqat Ali Khan was born in Elmore in India to a British Army senior officer whose Brahmin family was a recent convert to Christianity in 1887. She passed her matriculation from her native school. She got her BA Economics and BT in Religion Studies in 1927. Later, she obtained a double MSc in Economics and Sociology with honors in 1929. She began her career as a teacher in Gokhale Memorial School after completing the teacher's diploma course from the college, Calcutta. After her master's degree, Rana was appointed as professor of economics in Indraprastha College, University of New Delhi in 1931. Raj met Liaqat Ali Khan when he came there to deliver a lecture on law and justice at Indraprastha College, University in 1931. And in December 1932, she got married to Liaqat Ali Khan after embracing Islam. She changed her name from Sheila to Rana Liaqat Ali Khan, with her husband Rana strongly opposed the Salman Commission. While as professor of economics, Rana immensely mobilized students from her college and went to legislative assembly to hear her husband debate, carrying placards of Simon, go home. With Liaqat Ali Khan, winning the debate became an instant hero with her friends. She later sold him a ticket to a stage show to raise funds for flood relief in Bihar. Rana proved to be Liaqat Khan's constant partner and companion. She became politically involved with her husband and played a major role in Pakistan's movement. She became a defining moment in Pakistan's history when she accompanied her husband to London, the United Kingdom, in May 1933. There she and Khan met with Jinnah at Hampstead Health residence and successfully convinced Jinnah to return to British Indian Empire to resume the leadership of All India Muslim League. Jinnah returned to India and Rana was appointed as an executive member of Muslim League and chairperson of the economic division of the party. In 1942, when it became apparent that Imperial Japan was near attacking India, Jinnah summoned Rana, said to her, "Be prepared to train the women. Islam doesn't want women to be shut and never see fresh air." In order to understand this task, Rana became to organize Muslim Women presented itself in the same year when she formed a small volunteer medical corps for nursing and first aid in Delhi. Rana played an important role in creating political awareness among women. Rana was among the aspiring women in subcontinent and encouraged hundreds of women to fight for Pakistan shoulder to shoulder to men. After the creation of Pakistan, she became the first lady of the country. As a first lady, she initiates reform for women and child development social program of women and played a major role for women's part in Pakistan's politics. After the assassination of her husband Liaqat Ali Khan in 1951, Begum Rana continued her services for the social and economic benefit of women of Pakistan till her death in 1990. One of the daunting challenges for her was to organize health service for women and children migrating from India to Pakistan. After her husband's death, Rana went on to start her career as stateswoman that lasted more than two decades. In 1952, Rana was the first Muslim woman delegated to United Nations. 1952. In 1954, the government of Pakistan had appointed her as Pakistan's ambassador to Netherlands and also was the first woman ambassador of Pakistan. She represented Pakistan in Netherlands until 1961 and was also the doyen of diplomatic corps. In 1966 June, she was appointed as Pakistan ambassador to Italy and stayed there till 1965. Later was directed to Tunisia as Pakistan's ambassador and held this position until March 1966. Following her return to Pakistan, Rana joined Rana Liaquat Ali Khan Government College of Home Economics as Professor of Economics and stayed there until 1973. The Government College University awarded her honorary doctorate in economics and conferred her with a Doctor of Philosophy in Economics in 1967. And in 1972, as Pakistan was dismembered and going through an intense crisis, Rana joined hands with President Zulfikar Ali Bhutto and political movement and joined the socialist government of Zulfikar Ali Bhutto. Rana was part of Bhutto Ministry of Finance and Economics and played a major role, an influential role in decisions being made concerning economics. Bhutto encouraged her to participate in upcoming elections and won the election of 1973. Bhutto did not waste time and appointed Rana as governor of Sindh province. Rana was the first woman governor of province of Sindh and the first chancellor of Sindh University and Karachi University. She continued her term until 1976. When new elections were made, Rana again contested in 1977 parliamentary elections but did not take the office due to marital law imposed by General Ziaul Haq, Chief of Army Staff of Pakistan Army. She was one of the personalities that argued against marital law and execution of Bhutto. On a day when Bhutto was executed, Rana was reported to be disheartened and emotionally distressed and cried over Bhutto's death for more than 3 days constantly. Rana launched an anti-Zia campaign and fought against the military government of General Ziaul Haq. Guys, you are watching Desi TV USA. And for more information and news, please do like our channel, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon. This is our 24/7 streaming channel, and check out our sister channel as well, which is DTVNN, for more news and information. And you can use our sports channel, Desi TV Sports, and log into our website, which is DTVflix.com. to watch over 3,000 live channels, which can be in your own language, and you can watch your favorite sports and favorite things on this channel, which is absolutely free. So Allah Hafiz and goodbye for now, and stay safe and blessed for your loved ones.